You're such a terrible person! How could you even think of robbing an innocent like myself? Easy. You have no guards around your shop, and you'll forget who I am the second I walk out of this store. That's not true! I will never forget your face! I will never allow you to—
Hi, good sir. What can I get for you today?
Well, I just deconstructed all these stolen items, and now I'm here to sell them to you.
What stolen items?
Exactly.
Well, I'll buy whatever you're selling, unless it's stolen.
Well, technically, these are stolen goods, but I mean, they're just the components of the stolen goods.
Do you want my money or not?
Welcome, everybody, to another video on how to get filthy rich in The Elder Scrolls Online.
Indubitably.
So I released a money-making video a few months ago, which still works. There's nothing wrong with that video, except I found a way to make a ton of money way quicker. Selling your stolen items to the Thieves Guild isn't a bad thing, but I haven't sold them any armor or weapons in the longest time. Just the odd little trinkets and whatnot, just to level up my ledger domain. But now there's a new way to make money. This is a technique I like to call dancing. Now, when you dance, there's a certain DNA cell that takes over your body and makes you rich. Okay. Actually, this is a technique that most people don't even really take too seriously. People steal all the items they can and then just sell everything to the Thieves Guild. Well, no! You want to make money? Then no! Do not do that! Alright, you're probably all sick and tired of my little rant here, so now it's time to make some sweet, sweet moolah. What you're gonna be doing is stealing, emphasis on the word stealing, every single weapon and armor piece you can. Now, I've found some awesome locations to rob in each of the three factions. Get ready to empty your inventory, boys and girls, because you're going to go on a stealing spree.
Not a shopping spree.
For once, we'll start off with the Ebonheart Pact. As soon as I went to the main city of Daven's Watch in Stonefalls, I immediately found a place so amazing to rob, and the best part is that the vendors and guards barely look around there. So I'm trying my best here to show you exactly where this spot is. Now it's time. Steal everything from these little stores. They will not stand a chance. There are about 5 or 6 shops to rob, each ranging from heavy to light armor and weapons of all sorts, including staffs and bows. Just steal everything from here.
Alright, it's time for all you Aldemary Dominion folk to get your share of the stealing.
Head on over to the giant tree from Avatar, also known as Elden Root in Grantwood. This place is literally the jackpot for everything you need to steal. Every room has a specific purpose, whether that be for fighting, or alchemy, or enchanting, or the big nerd mages center. Go to the giant room with the huge sword banner in the front. This is the fighters area, and this is where you're gonna steal all the swords and armor you could ever dream of.
Swords and armor.
Just head on over to the back room and wow, look at all this stuff! It is truly my destiny to rob the innocent.
You know what to do next.
Finally, we're gonna hit the Daggerfall Covenant. Now, there are two places that I really like to steal from. The one location is in the city of Evermore in Bangkorai, which is shown in my blacksmithing video. In Evermore, there's a small back alley behind the Mystic Mortar, which is on the complete south side of the town. The other location of robbing is in the city of Shornhelm over in Rivenspire. There is this dorky little shop called
Western Boots and Apparel.
The store sells a ton of light and sometimes medium armors, and is a great place to rob because you can get caught, and there's only one guard that ever patrols the area, and they don't even come around. So basically, you're just free.
Let's see what the guards have to say about this.
Could you just be quiet? I'm trying to steal stuff here. Alright, so now your entire inventory is filled with all these stolen goods, it is time to use the word that I like to use best. Deconstruct!
Now this is the part where Kevin will deconstruct all of the items that he just stole.
Okay, so in order to deconstruct all of these stolen items, head on over to the nearest blacksmithing, clothing, or woodworking station. By deconstructing these items, it levels you up like crazy, gives you a ton of crafting resources like ingots, wood, pelts, and if you deconstruct a special item, you have the chance of getting some sort of quality upgrading tool. So now you have a ton of stuff, and it's time to do one of two options.
Two options? You think I can handle two options? I'm out of here! I'm handing myself over to the guards!
The first way requires you to use your top social skills.
Hi, I want to sell you today some bit of stuff that I deconstructed from a bunch of stolen items that I stole from you.
And the other way will actually make you a lot more money, but it requires you to be in a guild that frequently uses the guild store. Just go ahead and list your item in the guild store, and it will give you the suggested price. Try to be the best price in the shop, and your items will be sold a lot quicker. So, you're already guaranteed a cool 800 gold for every stack of items you get, and it's time for you to go and fulfill your destiny and rob the innocents. Fregland didn't rob the innocents. Look at him and laugh, everybody. Look and laugh. Anyways, thank you all for watching this crazy money-making video. But remember, when you become a rich snob, the best way to show it is to...
Don't stop, don't stop.